тебе боль.
Following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring, weighing in at 248 pounds, Connor O'Brien.
I wonder who has a bigger headache, Connor O'Brien from smashing that board across his forehead, or you having to talk with Titus O'Neil for that amount of time.
I'm glad he's gone.
You guys look like best friends out here.
He seems to think so.
Well, nevertheless, Connor O'Brien shocked himself with the way he was able to smash that board.
One can never wonder at the human mind. One puts one's mind to something, you can always achieve it. Did that sound good?
And weighing in at 254 pounds, Lucky Cannon!
So here comes Lucky Cannon, a part of NXT Season 2. This is NXT Redemption, William. Both of these rookies, another chance to make their dream come true, becoming a WWE superstar.
And for some of these rookies, it's the only chance. They have to make every single second count here because it is redemption. They have to redeem themselves in our eyes and in the WWE Universe's eyes.
Well, what's up? Apple of Lucky's eye, Maurice, not here tonight after what happened last night on Monday Night Raw at the hands of Karma. We've seen that in a few minutes.
But did you see the absolute look of terror and panic on Kelly's face? It was quite disturbing, actually.
Can you blame her?
No, not at all, no.
Lucky Cannon with his pro Tyson Kidd here tonight. And William, we've seen that you're in your battle gear, so to speak. You have a big match coming up against Jacob Novak.
Yes.
What are your thoughts as you prepare mentally for that?
Firstly, do you like my fake tan? I put some fake tan on today.
Did
to look,
you?
To look, I'm a bronze god.
Well, we are in Florida. Nice orange
yes.
look. I guess you're not too worried about it.
Of course I'm worried. I'm worried if I don't get up there and get my robe on, that's the best bit of my act.
Well, here we go. Lucky Cannon has his robe off and is going one-on-one against Connor O'Brien. Vladimir Kozlov has been trying to work his rookie into his own image.
We have to remember where this comes from as well, because Vladimir Kozlov and JTG had that bet a while ago. I didn't understand a word of it, but you tried to explain it to me. To make their rookie into a model of themselves, and it seems to me up to now JTG's doing actually the better job.
Jacob Novak's got the glasses that say yo, yo.
Yes.
He's got the big chains.
Yes, and he's lost all his brain power as well, just like JTG.
Zing.
A complete dribbling idiot.
Well, let's see if Connor O'Brien can become like Vladimir Kozlov. Otherwise, Vladimir said he will bring the pain. I don't want to know what that means.
I do know what that means, and I know that if anyone can bring pain, it's Vladimir Kozlov. Incredibly scary individual.
Do you like the way that Connor O'Brien has sort of evolved this season on NXT?
Yes. I've been, I can't say a fan, but I've been aware of Connor O'Brien for a long time, several years, and he's been learning his trade and learning the skills that you need to have to be a WWE competitor.
Did you see Lucky Cannon's pro Tyson Kidd provide the distraction?
I never see things like that because
you're a commentator now.
Trade.
You have to see these things.
I know, but old habits die hard.
Connor O'Brien more serious now. The smile is gone. He's more forceful. As for Lucky Cannon, he's more flamboyant. Delish, a.k.a. Mr. Steal Your Girl.
And has a lovely robe as well. Perhaps we can compare robes later. It'll be nothing like as elegant as mine.
Well, you're a former King of the Ring one.
Yes, for all of 6 weeks.
It happened,
yes.
In the annals of history. Both of these rookies would love to one day compete in a King of the Ring tournament. To do that, though, they have to impress their pros, and they have to impress the WWE Universe.
Both of these rookies, Lucky Cannon and Connor O'Brien, are definitely making an impression here. Lucky Cannon, from the very first week, though, of NXT Redemption, has been the standout star, in my opinion. He has been the man that has made more people lay their eyes on him, which is exactly what you need to do.
And Lucky's done that by not even competing in the challenges, has no redemption points.
But he's made himself noticeable. From last season, when he just blended in, and nobody really cared or knew about Lucky Cannon, Lucky Cannon has come out here with a game plan to make people hate him. And it works, because he's certainly the person that's got you know, the most effect by using the WWE Universe to his full advantage. And that's what you have to do. Make yourself stand out. I've said week after week, I could not have done, nor could really any of the top superstars in the WWE, do what these gentlemen are being asked to do. It's a very tough, very, very tough job to do, to stand out in a few weeks here. And they're doing a good job of it.
Lucky Cannon certainly has some buzz surrounding him, but Conor O'Brien, at least after what we've seen from him tonight, has got to be turning people's heads. Going toe-to-toe with Vladimir Kozlov, smashing boards across their faces, and now handing it to Lucky Cannon. And Lucky may have had enough.
Can you imagine the confidence that is built up now in Conor O'Brien?
Wait a second, what's Tyson Kidd doing again, getting involved?
Come on, you want to...
Seen Kozlov run this fast. And look, meanwhile, Conor O'Brien up and down. Lucky Cannon showing some strength here. Has he just beaten Conor? Yes, he has.
So you never know what's going to happen here in the WWE. I was just about to say,
winner, Lucky Cannon.
As I was saying, I was just about to say, can you imagine the confidence that is instilled in Conor O'Brien breaking that board by Vladimir Kozlov talking him into it? It will have instilled a lot of confidence, but Tyson Kidd saw the advantage and helped his rookie out, and so good for him, they're winners.
A big win by Lucky Cannon last week over Byron Saxton, and again tonight against Conor O'Brien. But as I mentioned, William, Maurice not here tonight, and we're about to see why. Let's take